Never mind Carl Van Dibble. Maybe it should be Carl Van Dollars. Welcome to Facts of Fishing FYI, the fishing news, views, and info you can't use show. Let's jump right into it. This past week, Texas game wardens received an anonymous call about an excessive amount of crappie carcasses found in Lake of the Pines. When they showed up to investigate, shocker, this was not a massive crappie beaching. These fish had already been filleted. So then the search was on, following all sorts of hints, which I am assuming included the sweet smell of fish fry. They came across two anglers that had, are you ready for this? 350 crappie. That's right. Two anglers with 350 crappie in their possession. Or roughly 173 over the Texas state possession limit. I mean, I love fish fry, but that would make Daryl Cronzy blush. In the fishing world, when the bite gets hot, word spreads quickly. And that is literally what has happened recently in Australia. Anglers from all over Australia are flocking to fish spots in southeast Tasmania, Australia, following the escape of an estimated 50,000 salmon during a recent fish farm fire. Now that's a hot bite, mate. Did you know that some ocean fish live so deep they would literally melt if you brought them to the surface? That's right. The Marina snailfish has been observed as deep as depths of 8,178 meters deep, or roughly a little more than 5 feet down. Their gelatinous structure means they're perfectly adapted for living in extreme pressure situations. And in fact, the hardest structure in their bodies is their teeth. If you were to bring them up to the surface and hold it in your hand, it would literally melt. As we've reported in the past, due to COVID, more people are fishing, and some recent corporate earnings back that up. Recently, Pure Fishing's financial rating was raised by Moody Investor Services, and now Johnson Outdoors, owners of Hummingbird, Minn Kota, and many other brands, are reporting a 58% raise in revenue in the fourth quarter, with the fishing division sales grew 70.3% from $66.9 million to $113.9 million. But that's not all. How about KVD, as in Carl Van Dibble of Mystery Tackle Box fame? Catch Gold, the Chicago-based digital sport fishing brand, has closed on a $6 million funding round led by existing investor Listen Ventures. Catchco reports year-over-year growth rates approaching 100%. In 2021, you ready for this? Catchco expects to deliver over 2.5 million mystery tackle boxes. Never mind Carl Van Dibble. Maybe it should be Carl Van Dollars. This past weekend marked the final Bassmaster event of the 2020 season, the Bassmaster Team Championship. An Alabama Bass Trail powerhouse team, Wesley Sams and Jordan Wiggins, took the W on the Harris Chain of Lakes. Sam and Wiggins, who hail from Cullman, Alabama, bagged a 5-bass limit that weighed 22 pounds, 5 ounces. From there, the top three were all separated. It became a 6-angler individual 2-day fish-off with a Bassmaster Classic berth on the line. When it was all said and done, Jordan Wiggins wins the Classic fish-off, and he'll represent the Alabama Bass Trail at the Bassmaster Classic in Fort Worth, Texas. So today is 10 days until Christmas Eve, so we might as well finish with some festive stories. First of all, congrats to the over 300 anglers that helped Toys for Tots and set a world record this past weekend at the Ugly Stick Santa Claus Bass Tournament. The world truly needs more events like this. And finally, if you're not in the Christmas mood, this should seal the deal. Former Forcewood Cup champion Brad Knight decided to give his beautiful daughter, Tinsley, a puppy for Christmas. And if this doesn't make your eyes wet, you may be the Grinch.
Open your eyes up. What do you think?
Oh, do you think?
Thank you.
Oh, you're welcome.